Walker Farms, a family-owned honeybee farm in Fort Myers, Florida, specializes in everything honey and often finds their business suffering because of the inconsistencies with the climate, which create even more inconsistencies among the honeybee population and their honey production.
There's probably 25% of a crop simply because it was warm, a warm winter. It got warm too soon, and the bees weren't able to build up numbers enough to make the crop. The crop came and went before the bees were ready because of the environment. As far as the environment goes, it's a gamble with pesticides and poison water and whatever it is that kills lots of things, not just bees, insects. And the mosquito spray, for example, they spray that stuff, it kills everything. Butterflies, flies, wasps, worms, everything is going on as far as the cycle of our nature. That stuff doesn't help at all.
Insects don't have internal temperature control. They instead are reliant upon the environment for that. So if the temperature gets warmer, then that means that they aren't as able to fight the effects of that increase in temperature as, say, you or I might be.
Changes in the Earth's atmosphere are not only jeopardizing the existence of honeybees, but other large species are also in danger.
There's an old rule of thumb that beekeepers have been talking for years and years and years. They say if you take all the bees out of our world, out of our, think about it, existence, that we'll follow in 4 years. The truth of the matter is we probably wouldn't starve. We wouldn't eat as well. Our woods won't be pollinated. Our wild plants, our things won't do as well.
Dr. Joyce Fassbender advises us to alter our pesticide usage to where we only use it when it is absolutely necessary and try not to use broad spectrum pesticides.
You have to have bees for the good of Mother Nature.